Hi, thank you for chatting with me. I know we don't have a lot of time, so I'm going to get right to it. This film, I think, is incredibly fascinating because there are many stories about sexual harassment, sadly, that we could tell. But this one centers women who, there's a perception about them that they are part of this machine that exploits people and women. And I wonder if you could just talk a little bit about you know, what it means to you to be bringing this story and finding their humanity and empathy in these characters.
Yeah, there's a huge part that is that definitely lies in that truth. Mm-hmm. And I even think, you know, individually, these women at some point have been somewhat hypocritical when it comes to sexual harassment. And within all of that, I think what I've discovered is the importance of an issue like sexual harassment, and that if it can lie in a space like that where I don't necessarily feel like I'm that emotionally invested and but yet still care, it tells me that the issue is very real. Mm-hmm. And that if I want to rectify that, I can't pick and choose who that's going to be for. Right. You know, we want equality. We need to have it for everybody, and that might not necessarily be always the people that we are like-minded or that we see eye to eye with. And in this case, that was very true for me.
Yeah. How about you, Margot? Did you want to weigh in on that?
Or? Yeah, no, I mean, I think I feel like the Me Too movement and the Time's Up movement was ignited first initially here with this scandal and the accusations against Roger Ailes. And then next, I think the next big one was Harvey Weinstein. And I think it's interesting, perhaps, that those two places both seemingly lean one way politically and very far the other way politically as well. And it really just shows us that this isn't a bipartisan issue. It's not you have to take politics and your point of view on people out of it, and because sexual harassment doesn't discriminate. And of course, these are two platforms where the people, you know, it's a very publicly open place and these people are recognizable, so of course it's gained traction when these stories have come forward in these two particular work environments. But at the same time, I think people would consider Fox News incredibly right and Hollywood incredibly left.
Oh my gosh, I can't get fired. This is the only job I have ever wanted. I don't want to be on TV. I want to be on Fox.
Uh-huh.
My family, every day, every holiday, like especially holidays, we watch Fox News. We're like addicts. Fox is how we do church. You know when they made the corner logo turn? Because folks had Fox burned into their TV screens? That's us.
Kayla, you're not getting fired. He cannot scale his anger. He's a perpetual outrage machine. That's why crazies love him. No offense to your family. You want to do the folders?
No crying at Fox.
No crying.
Yeah. I have to ask you, because I'm with the advocate, I have to ask you about Kayla and this fling slash friendship with Kate McKinnon's character. And this was such a surprising, really interesting piece of this film. And I just wonder if you could talk to what it means to you to be able to bring that piece of it. It's kind of, these women aren't monolithic and neither is your Megan. So I wonder if you just speak to what that means to you to be able to flesh that out as well. This kind of modern fluidity.
Yeah. I often say this, but I find my character so much through their interactions with the other actors that I'm working with. And I got to, luckily for me, do so much of this film with Kate McKinnon, who's incredible, and people are going to see a side to her acting that they rarely get to see in this film. But we also get to have a lot of fun together, and she really is the person who takes Kayla under her wings at Fox News and gives her the lay of the land. And then they have a kind of unexpected hookup, which on the page, even I was like, oh my God! I think it was written...
Can conservatives do that?
And I was like, oh, they're in bed together. I think it was written like, we're surprised, but kind of not surprised as well. And you're like, yeah, it's kind of true, but I think it just... You know, for story-wise, it adds to the idea that they they can't come forward and be open and honest, and their jobs are on the line. And though both Jess and Kayla don't really have the political clout that Megan and Gretchen have, they still have their jobs at stake. And Jess, though she's not experiencing sexual harassment the way in the way that Kayla is, she has her own reasons to feel oppressed at work, in her work environment. And that just also means that she doesn't feel comfortable coming forward with Kayla at that time.
Isn't it great though that there's a relationship like that in the film and we don't necessarily explain it? It's just there.
To me that was just, I just
love that there's a space for these relationships and these characters to kind of live and breathe without some kind of like underlining explanation of like, why did she do it? And
it was such a fascinating part of Kayla to explore that in the film. I think she ends up in one place emotionally, and her point of view on politics and the world and this institution that she's grown up in, those views are completely shattered and she pieces them back together, and by the end she has a totally different worldview. So in some ways she has grown and evolved in a magnificent way in this film. But in other ways, especially when it comes to sexuality, she's totally compartmentalized that, and it's something she's not dealing with in this film. By the end of the film, she hasn't dealt with it. As an actor, that gave such dimension to the character that she, in some ways, was acknowledging certain truths about the world and in other ways really wasn't. To me, that just, really added and informed me on who she was.